I'm Avon.
I'm Christina.
And I'm Kate.
Today we are dishing from Napoleon Bistro Lounge, located at 1847 Columbia Road in Adams Morgan, home of the delightfully decadent Nutella Espresso.
And our guest today is Jenny Abramson, who is the publisher of FW.
Fashion Washington is something that I look forward to every time it comes out, but I feel like it doesn't come out often enough. What, it comes out just a couple of times a year? How often does it come out?
It's actually seasonal, although we added an extra issue this week, this year, because our readers and our advertisers asked for it. So I think you're not the only one that feels that way.
I am sure they did ask for it. And one reason that I ask for it every time is because it's the only magazine, sorry the rest of the magazines, I do love you, but it's the only magazine in town that actually does its pictorial images here in Washington that I know of anyway.
Am I wrong? Washington Life, madam?
I've never been able to notice then that they were filming at Monuments. Okay, well Washington Life does, sorry. But I mean, this is incredible. It's beautiful.
The city is a backdrop here.
Yeah. The city is a backdrop.
But what was the idea behind doing this type of actual editorial? I mean, for example, it's the length of the paper versus having,
right,
you know, half the insert of the size wise. Yeah. So what was the idea behind that?
Well, the idea behind the whole publication was, we actually thought, I know most people think DC's only been fashionable since Michelle Obama. We actually think DC is pretty fashionable and has been for a few years, and we felt like there was an opportunity to really cover that and that there are sophisticated shoppers here that want to know the best of what's in Washington and how these national trends sort of translate here. Mm-hmm. And it's not all navy blue suits. And there's some beautiful places to actually cover fashion. So whether it's the Corcoran Gallery of Art, or AFI Theater, or our upcoming fall issue, which is actually at the National Gallery's Sculpture Garden, which is very fitting, because as you know, the trends for fall are all architectural structured items, so it's gonna be a beautiful shoot.
I do wanna talk about trends for fall, but since you brought it up, I have to say, I have some beef with this.
Oh, I didn't really answer your question. So why advertisers love it, because they can actually display their stuff, and actually a lot of our readers like to be able to see big, beautiful pages.
Oh, so there's a lot more space.
Advertisers love it because it looks like an advertising section. In my opinion, I wanted it to be, I'm sorry, I'm putting you on the spot.
I wanted it to be
more like the New York Times magazine, where it was like a glossy magazine inside.
We thought a lot about it, but it's been a fun way to differentiate from other magazines.
Sure.
And when we talk about these gorgeous places around the city, there's something incredible when you can really show picture. I mean, we'll often do a spread in an issue,
and
you have this huge canvas to actually show photography. I mean, it's really
just like
incredible.
This is Glen Echo, I take it. So Glen Echo, you know, it's brilliant. It's beautiful.
Yeah.
Color.
It's just beautiful space.
That's what we love.
It's a spring,
and one of the things we've done that's been really fun is we've given a number of copies to some of our post readers, and it comes on top of the paper.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So it's sort of a neat way for them to get a product.
So it's a unique subscription?
It's a regular part of papers where we target in areas where we think there's a lot of shoppers.
Okay.
And then we make sure anyone who wants it can get it. So we actually are at now 50 salons, boutiques, and hotels around the city. So it's on our website where to get it. We pretty much made it, if you want to read FW, it's pretty easy to get it.
So is it a quarterly? Does it normally come quarterly?
It's quarterly, and then we this year added an issue just to get people through summer.
Okay.
So that you can be fashionable in the summer in D.C. So we added that issue.
If you're still here.
And pretty important, since I think it kind of takes the place sometimes of the style section. Whenever you're looking for style in the more like clothing
fashion.
Fashion sense, and less in a what happened around town kind of way.
We definitely focus a lot on sort of the hottest boutiques,
new
sort of designers, how trends sort of translate here. We do a little of the social scene, but it tends to be, as you all know, since some of you have been profiled in it, much more about what did someone wear at that event, as opposed to just who's at what party.
True.
And that's been sort of the FW angle. Our editors have done a great job of that.
Do you think Michelle Obama is good for high fashion in D.C.? You know, we see her in Target dresses, and we see her in J.Crew. Right, and then we see beautiful photography like this, you know, of an amazing shoe, but this is not a Target shoe.
Yeah. No.
And, you know, and so in some ways I feel like there are two universes. When people say fashion Washington these days, you know, you have real high fashion.
Yeah.
And then, I mean, what do you think the Michelle effect is?
Well, I mean, I think Michelle Obama's been great for Washington in general, because I think that it was already a pretty hip place. and she is helping give that attention in the rest of the country and showing people that. I do think in FW we try to cover a range of fashions, and I think Michelle Obama actually has a range herself. I mean,
I agree.
Her Jason Wu dress and other things certainly are on the higher end. But we do aim a slightly sort of higher end, and but it doesn't have to all be a fortune, and it can. Some of the items that we feature are less expensive, or from small boutiques all around the area.
That's kind of what I really like about what FW is doing, because it actually brings in the local boutiques and local designers and local retail places. So it's not just you know, something you can buy from you know, online or from New York or somewhere else. You can actually go down the street and actually purchase it. So that's
and I think our editors have really tried to sort of embed themselves in the local life. Actually, the fashion bloggers, we think, started that conversation long before we got to the table. And so we took a page out of your book, because we've tried to sort of continue that in print and online in our own way. But a lot of that has been getting to know the boutique owners all around the city, in Old Town, in Bethesda, Chevy Chase. So.
And the new issue is just about to come out. I know that you're still working on it. Can you give us any just ideas about what to expect?
Yes, I'd be happy to. Give you a little sneak peek. Our fall issue, as I mentioned, is going to have our fashion shoot at the National Gallery Sculpture Garden, which will be a cool way to show the structural items that people are wearing, ruffles and a little less of the romantic flowery look. We're also going to get into pleated pants, which I don't know if you kept yours from the 1980s, but they're back.
Really?
So, you know, not MC Hammer, but they're back. We'll talk a little bit about how men who date women who are fashionable, how it impacts their wardrobe. And so
it helps. Well, they throw out the pleated pants.
Exactly.
We'll
do our regular Q&A. And of course, we've got our party where we'll capture some of the exciting, our scene stealers, where we'll capture what people are wearing at some hot parties. And we have our first anniversary. I mean, this is our first anniversary issue. So I know you were at our party last year. This is not public yet, but we are going to have a party on October 19th, so your viewers can know it first at a hot new restaurant.
You heard it first, hot new restaurant, there's the dish.
And if viewers want to come, or readers want to come, look at our issue out September 16th to find out how to sign up for tickets to this exclusive event. We'll have the sartorialist there talking about his new book, so make sure you come well-dressed, because he'll be snapping up photos.
I love the stuff in GQ. I mean,
you guys are all invited. So
everyone is going to be running out to get their issue of the Post, so they can get the FW and find out how to get that.
So,
I can't wait.
It should be very fun. So September 16th, the issue comes out, and it's, you go to our website and go to Get FW, you can find out where to get it.
I'll Get FW to figure out what to wear to the October party.
Exactly.
That's it.
Well, we look forward every season to finding out what you think is hot and fashionable here in Washington. We're so glad that you're publishing this, and we're so glad that you came on with us. Thank you so much.
Thank you guys. I'm a huge fan. Thank you so much.
And as always, thank you for watching us. Check back here next time on The District Dish.